Eerandel, the oldest star ever observed, is hidden somewhere in this James Webb picture. And I bet you're not able to spot it. But fear not, we will soon arrive at that point. However, before we do, let's delve into the workings of lenses. These remarkable devices can manipulate light, bending its beams in ways that may appear magical, but are simply rooted in basic physics. You may wonder about the connection between a lens and the universe's oldest star. The link is more significant than you might imagine. Allow me to guide you through this video where all your questions will be answered. Additionally, I will reveal how the discovery of Eerandel holds the potential to unveil the enigmatic secrets of the Big Bang. A puzzling enigma. So where is Eerandel in this picture? Is it going to be one of those big lights in the center? No, they are elliptical galaxies. Unlike spirals with arms or irregular ones with chaotic shapes, elliptical galaxies appear symmetrical and lack distinctive features. They are composed mostly of older stars and contain little interstellar gas and dust. They come in various sizes, from small to supergiant, and are often found in the central regions of galaxy clusters. Their formation is linked to processes such as galaxy mergers, where smaller galaxies combine to create a larger, elliptically shaped galaxy. Is it going to be the six spikes prominent star in the center? Nah, that's a star belonging to our galaxy. These spikes are an optical artifact known as diffraction spikes, which are caused by the telescope's design. If astronomers observe a star with six spikes in Webb's images, it serves as a visual cue that the star is part of our Milky Way galaxy. This phenomenon is a product of the telescope's optics and is not present in stars from other galaxies captured in the telescope's images. It's an interesting feature that aids astronomers in differentiating between stars within our galaxy and those in more distant galaxies when analyzing James Webb Space Telescope observations. So where is it? Spotting Eerandel. It's here. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the oldest star known in the universe. You sense the thrill and adrenaline coursing through your veins and along your spine. If not, take a moment to contemplate this marvel. As demonstrated earlier, each object in this image, except for the hexagonally spiked stars, represents an individual galaxy. Numerous galaxies grace this image, and Eerandel is no exception. Like every other star, it resides within a galaxy known as the Sunrise Arc Galaxy. As you may observe, this galaxy stands out among its counterparts, hinting at some intriguing phenomena. I'll delve into that shortly, but first, a question for you. Ever ponder the difficulty observing a single star in a galaxy teeming with millions, no, billions of stars? Just to offer a perspective, consider Andromeda, one of the Milky Way's closest neighbors. Extensively studied, it's destined to collide with our galaxy. Although not to worry, such an event is far beyond our lifetimes. Returning to our discussion, when we gaze upon galaxies like Andromeda through instruments like the Hubble Space Telescope, we primarily see the brighter-than-average stars. However, these are merely a fraction of the galaxy's countless stars. Skeptical? Allow me to illustrate. I'll zoom into the sharpest view of the Andromeda galaxy ever captured by Hubble, showcasing its breathtaking expanse. The deeper you zoom, the more stars come into view, an endless sea of light and stars. Distinguishing one star from another becomes a formidable task. Yet when we direct our gaze towards galaxies much farther away, the resolution of our telescopes prevents such detailed appreciation. We perceive only the galaxy's form and perhaps some broad features. This holds true for the majority of galaxies in the James Webb image. Thus, spotting a solitary star within a galaxy, specifically identifying Eerandel within the Sunrise Arc Galaxy, is no easy feat. In fact, it would be impossible if not for a remarkable natural occurrence. Gravitational lensing. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve it for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Gravitational lensing. Imagine the universe as a vast landscape and galaxies as massive mountains within it. Light is a traveler journeying across the cosmos. As the light travels, it follows a straight path through space, much like a hiker climbing a hill. However, when our light traveler approaches a massive galaxy, the gravitational field of the galaxy warps the space around it, creating a gravitational well, a deep valley in our landscape analogy. As a result, the straight path of the light gets curved by this gravitational well, like a hiker's path bending as they descend into the valley. Now consider a distant object, such as a background galaxy or a star, located behind our massive galaxy. The light from this background object must pass through the gravitational well created by the foreground galaxy on its way to our observer, like a hiker on the other side of the valley. The gravitational field bends the light, causing it to follow a curved path. From the observer's perspective, this bending of light creates a distorted and magnified image of the background object. It's as if the foreground galaxy acts as a giant lens, focusing and magnifying the light from the distant object. This phenomena allows astronomers to study objects that would otherwise be too faint or distant to observe directly. It acts as a natural telescope, providing a unique window into the universe's more distant and hidden corners. Gravitational lensing is therefore what gives the peculiar shape to the Sunrise Arc galaxy, where Eerandel belongs. And it is also the reason why we are able to see Eerandel itself. The star is 12.9 billion light-years away from us, and it holds the record as the furthest star ever observed. Despite the immense distance traveled, the light from Eerandel has finally reached the James Webb Space Telescope, thanks to the gravitational lens magnifying its luminosity more than 40,000 times. This amplification is made possible by the presence of the colossal galaxy cluster WHL-0137-08 between the Sunrise Arc galaxy and us. Eerandel's light originated within the universe's first billion years, making it a remarkable discovery from a time when the universe was vastly different from today. It is possible that Eerandel belongs to the first generation of stars ever created, with its birth occurring less than a month after the Big Bang if we imagine the time from the Big Bang to today as a whole year. Truly incredible, isn't it? The term Eerandel originated from the ancient English language meaning morning star or rising light. Furthermore, Eerandel is not only the name given to a semi-elf character in J.R.R. Tolkien's renowned book, The Silmarillion, but also refers to an individual who journeyed across the heavens carrying a luminous gem that shone brightly like a star. Remarkably, Michelle Toller, an astronomer at NASA, has confirmed that the intentional allusion to Tolkien's work was made in this discovery. Webb's findings. Although Hubble first discovered Eerandel, it is the James Webb Space Telescope that has provided us with unprecedented detail. Here's exactly how it went. In March of 2022, Hubble revealed the existence of Eerandel to the world. Just a few months later, in July, Webb released its initial images and announced its readiness to commence scientific operations. Among its first observations was Eerandel, and now the findings from that observation have been made public. Webb's investigation of Eerandel went beyond simply capturing images with a camera. It also employed a spectrometer. This instrument separates the star's light into different components, enabling us to gain a deeper understanding of its characteristics. Through spectroscopy, stars are classified based on the appearance of their spectra, designated by letters ranging from O to M in sequential order. Although it may seem arbitrary, this classification system has a rich historical background that we may delve into at a later time. The data collected by Webb indicates that Eerandel belongs to the main sequence and is classified as a B-type star. Main sequence refers to stars in their prime, neither too young nor close to their demise. B-type stars are large and hot, with some exceeding twice the size of our Sun, and radiating temperatures in the thousands of degrees. To the human eye, they typically appear blue. An example of B-type stars in the constellation Orion is Bellatrix, located on Orion's shoulder, and Rigel, situated at his knee during winter. Stars like Eerandel are often part of binary systems, accompanied by a smaller and dimmer companion. Detecting such a companion at Eerandel's distance poses significant challenges. Even in our own Milky Way, locating a companion star can be elusive. However, the absence of visibility does not preclude the existence of a companion. Educated conjecture becomes necessary. Webb's spectroscopic analysis of Eerandel's light reveals subtle indications of not only Eerandel's radiance, but also a cooler, dimmer, and redder companion. What makes this discovery partially fascinating is that the wavelengths of this companion's light lie beyond Hubble's observational range. Hubble, by design, would have been unable to detect the companion. Webb, on the other hand, possesses the necessary capabilities, allowing for the revelation of hidden phenomena when these two telescopes collaborate. The aspect of their partnership is truly captivating. The importance of Eerandel. The observation of Eerandel provides astronomers with a novel opportunity to explore the characteristics of the early universe. Our understanding of stellar physics relies on the assumption that all stars throughout the universe share properties akin to those observed in the vicinity of our Milky Way. Specifically, the first stars that emerged in the universe are believed to be composed solely of hydrogen and helium, known as Population 3 stars, although they have never been directly observed. The ability to observe a star from such a remote distance enables us to scrutinize the validity of this hypothesis. This scrutiny is crucial as it has the potential to challenge our existing knowledge about the universe. Will James Webb confirm this is indeed a Population 3 star? We'll be sure to keep you updated. That's all for this video. What are your thoughts on Eerandel? Let us know in the comments below. We'll see you next time on the channel.